Welcome to the Sunday Reach by the Dominicans. We are in the fourth Sunday of the Easter. The fourth Sunday speaks about the Good Shepherd. Jesus presents himself as a Good Shepherd. My dear brothers and sisters, we look around our life in the world at different levels. We see the leadership. We see the political leadership at different stages. We see the corporate leadership with CEOs, managers, supervisors, project managers. We see the leadership in social life. We see the leadership in religious life, again, at different levels. Then we have professionals, we have doctors. At certain extent, they too become leaders because they take care of their patients. We have nurses, again, they have their patients to take care of them. We have teachers who take care of the students, and so on. So the leadership list is a large list. Many of us are born leaders, others are made leaders. Others, some of them, happen to be leaders. Whatever we may be, we have the world open to be the leaders. But when we look at the leadership, no matter from which angle that does come, whether it is a spiritual leadership or a political or a social or a corporate, we see the goals of this leadership is basically to fulfill their aims and their projects. In that sense, the leadership has become to make sure that profits are done. So the political leadership is a selfish leadership where they are interested only in their own gains, in their own profits, in their own win and success. The corporate leadership, they are anxious and concerned about to complete their projects, make sure that the projects are completed. In the bargain, there's no much respect for those people who work under them. There is no humanness involved. There is no respect as the other person is made as a machine or an equipment, not as human person. Although in this field, we see lots of incentives are being given, but again, these incentives that are given for the sake of a better productivity and more outputs, nothing for the sake of people themselves. We see the failures of leadership in social life. Again, there's a lot of selfishness and greed involved. In the medical line, doctors out of their, maybe in the government hospitals and so on, where they need to see lots of patients, where they may lose their genuinity to be the doctors, a person-oriented doctor, and as a result, again, it's just that medical level, they look at the patients and then they treat. For the nurses, probably it is their profession, it is their occupation. It is their earning. We have teachers, again, how much honestly and genuinely they will be taking care of the children and going out of their way to help the little ones. Again, there we may see it's just the duty, and of course they are being paid for it. We also have the leadership in the church, in the spiritual level. Again, there is a huge failure in the leadership because of the lethargy, the comfort, and the minimum thing that they have to live and survive. Again, here the leadership has failed. But today's world is looking for a leadership, and this leadership will be successful if we take into consideration the qualities of Jesus as a good shepherd. So let us try to find out few qualities of Jesus as a good shepherd. Shepherd is always a leader. First of all, Jesus being the good shepherd, he loves his flock. And that's the thing. So every leader under his care, the people has to be loved. Secondly, Jesus being the good shepherd will take his sheep to to the best of the pastures. So he feeds them, and that is his main concern, to feed his flock. And for us Catholics, till today, Jesus feeds us with his body and blood. So Jesus continues to be our food in his word and in his body and blood. So a leader, a shepherd, has to be the one who is concerned with the food of his flock. Jesus, as a good shepherd, takes care of his sheep, so that, you know, if something goes wrong, he makes sure that he will take care of those wounded ones or the sick ones or handicapped ones. The very interesting character of Jesus as good shepherd in today's gospel, he tells that he's a shepherd who will protect the sheep from the violence or attacks of the wild animals. And so he's not a shepherd who will run away when there are crises, when there are struggles, but he's a shepherd. He will be there, he will wait, he will protect, he'll take care of the sheep. And it's not only that, he also speaks today in today's gospel that there are other sheep who do not belong to his own flock, and he is concerned about them. He said, I should also reach out to them. They also should listen to my voice. So he's concerned. He's going beyond his limits. He's going out of his way, and he wants to be the shepherd of the flock that does not belong to his flock as well. And you see his concern, his love, his attention to the flock that is beyond his reach. And at the end, he lays down his life for his sheep. So you see how for him, his sheep is more important than his life itself, and he is ready. And that's exactly Jesus being God, and he came down to earth to save us his flock. For that, he was ready to lay down his life. He says that it is by own will that I lay down my life. It's not by force, because he knew that it is only by his blood that we could be saved. And so he was ready to give up his life, to the extent it's not simply that he gave up his life for us in order to save us, but the torture, the pain, the wounds, the cross that he had to undergo. And this was not easy, and we know that. We have reflected just a few days back during the Lent season, the pain and the sufferings of Jesus. So you see, laying down his very life to save his flock. My dear brothers and sisters, these are some of the qualities the good shepherd has in his life. That's Jesus. Today, the world is in need of good shepherds. Today, the world is in need of good leaders. Leaders who will care for a sheep. Leaders who will go out of their way to reach out for their sheep. The leaders who will make sure they are being fed. Above all, what we lack today in our leadership is that humanness. What we lack today in our leadership is the concern. We look at our own subjects as machines, as commodities, that they have to work certain hours or they have to produce certain products. That's not the way. We, at the end of the day, are human. No matter how big is your corporate world, how large is your projects, human beings remain human beings. And every leader, first and foremost, has to respect those who work under him as human beings. No doubt, whether you are a manager, you are a doctor, you are a nurse, you are a teacher, you are a religious leader or a political leader, every person under our care are human beings, and they deserve respect. They deserve respect of a human person. So that's important. If every person looks at the other person from this perspective of human beings, then automatically there will be the rest of the characteristics of the good shepherd leader would be found in us. Jesus treated every human person as a human person, as creation of God, and therefore they deserved to be saved. That was the concept. They are creatures. They are created by God, and therefore they deserve to be saved and not to be lost. And this is his concept. With that, he respected the creation, and out of their respect and love, his concern to save them. And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, let us read this passage more deeply, reflect, meditate, and try to live the characters of Jesus in our life and reach out to people out of our way, beyond our limits, and care for the flock that is given to our care. And this way, let us win these people for God, and let us win our souls as well to God.